Hello, my name is Dom, and today I'll be showing you how to integrate Smartproxy scrapers with serverless functions using webhooks. So today we're going to create a quick little project where we scrape information from the internet, we push the data via a webhook to a serverless function, and we save the data to a database. We're going to be doing everything serverless, so we don't actually have to manage any infrastructure ourselves. So first things first, go to the Smartproxy dashboard, and on the side menu, open up the scraping product line and select SERP. Quick note that if you don't have a subscription, you won't see the option to save a new scraper, but we offer free trials, so you can try it for free. Okay, so to get started, let's go to the Smartproxy dashboard. On the side menu, let's open up the SERP product and let's create a new project. Now for today, I'm just gonna be picking up information from Google search, but we have a whole bunch of targets that are gonna meet different needs that you may have. Now in Google search, we're just gonna scrape for pizza. We're gonna assume we're a pizza parlor in New Zealand, and we wanna make sure that we're at the top of the search results. So over here, we have a playground where we can try out our requests. If we hit start scraping, we can see the results that we get if we look for pizza on Google search. So you can see Pizza Hut is showing up as number one. At position two, we have Domino's. And next up, we have Wikipedia. Now, these actual results are randomized because they may be coming from a different geolocation. If you want to have a specific geolocation, you can pick it here in parameters. Now for today, we're just gonna go with New Zealand. I'm gonna double check that we actually get domains that come from New Zealand. So over here, we can see that Domino's co.nz is number one. We have Pizza Hut. And then we have this ordermeal.com. Our goal is to track Google search positions for pizza to make sure that we're at the top. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to save a new scraper. Now, after creating a scraper, I can go back to it and I'll have this option to create a schedule. Schedules allow you to automatically scrape results for your query and your parameters, and to also have all those results delivered to your selected destination. So we're gonna click on schedule over here. Now you have an option to select how frequently you wish to receive your results. For the purposes of today, I'm just gonna make a custom cron expression that's gonna fetch the results each minute. And in terms of delivery method, I'm gonna select webhook. Now, when you're working with webhooks, what really helps is to have a website that captures network requests so you can trial and debug things as you're developing things. What I'm going to be using for today is called webhook.site, but frankly, any website that supports webhooks is going to work. I'm going to copy over this webhook URL, and I'm going to drop it over here into our scraper. And I'm going to hit save. All we have to do right now is to wait for a minute to get our results into our webhook. Okay, so after a minute or so, you should be able to see a request over here, and we can see our results, and we can see Domino's on top, followed by, where's this, Pizza Hut, and Order Meal. So the results are the same as we tried out on the playground in the scraper. So next, we need to put all of this into a Lambda function that's gonna save it to a database. There's many cloud providers that provide serverless functions, but for today, we're gonna be using Cloudflare because it's fairly easy to set up. When you go to Cloudflare's dashboard, you're gonna click over here to create a new worker. Now for this guy, we're gonna call him Pizza Scraper. And we're gonna deploy. Once the worker is deployed, you're gonna have a global link where you can call it. And we're gonna go edit some code. Now, since we'll be pushing information, we wish to post to our serverless function. So we're gonna select the post method over here. Inside of the body, we're gonna pick up the content that we had from our webhook site, and we're gonna drop it as the body here. It's gonna be easier to sort of see what's happening. Okay, so we're gonna start by trying to fetch the very first URL, and then if it works, we're gonna connect it to the database. First, we're gonna call the JSON function to extract the body from the request. Log our body. We can see we have a results in object with the results key. We can just unwrap this object one property at a time to make sure we get to where we want to. Cloudflare can be eager to invoke your code every time you make a change. If you want to have a new run, just make sure to hit send over here. Type out new props, clear the output, and rerun the request. And you can see the organic key over here. And we can see the URL. Okay, so we can save all of this as the URL. And next up, we're gonna load this URL into Cloudflare's database. We're gonna go back to Cloudflare's dashboard. We're gonna go on the one over here, and we're gonna create a new database. We're gonna do it in the dashboard itself, but you can also use the CLI. Gonna call it PizzaDB, and we're gonna hit create. We're gonna create a new table. We're just gonna call our table pizza. And we're gonna have two columns, an ID for our primary key, and the URL as a string. Now, note that if you create an integer and you set it as primary key, Cloudflare is basically gonna treat it as the auto increment integer. So you don't have to actually input a value for it. Cloudflare is gonna automatically put in a value. So let's hit create. And we have our pizza table. If we want, we can actually go inside of the table and try to add some sample data. And you can see that the ID is generated for us. We don't actually have to input it. Okay, once we have our database created, we need to bind it to our worker. We're gonna go back to our worker over here. First, we're gonna deploy our changes. Then we're gonna come back to our worker. We're gonna go on settings. We're gonna go on variables. Now over here, you're gonna find D1 database bindings. Add binding. This variable is gonna be the variable in code, which we actually use to interact with our database. And we're gonna say that DB equals pizza DB. And we're gonna hit deploy. So if you head on over to Cloudflare's docs for D1, you're gonna see how to use the database in a function. So we just created our database and bind it to the DB variable, although we use lowercase. We're gonna make a prepared SQL statement. We're gonna put in our queries, and we're gonna commit the statement by using the all function. So we can actually pick up the example over here. Okay, make sure that this DB over here is lowercase, just like we did it in the settings. And we're gonna insert into pizza values question mark. This question mark over here will be binded to the URL variable over here. This whole thing is called a prepared statement. Frankly, it's not the nicest way to work with SQL, but this is what Cloudflare provides out of the box. Okay, and we're gonna call all to commit the changes. So let's quickly try and send a request. Okay, so we got no errors. And if we open up the database column over here, we can see that we have two rows, Domino's Co. and Z. Now again, Cloudflare is eagerly restarting the worker. We can just delete one row. So once we know that a sample payload is saved to our database correctly, we can go back to Smartproxy dashboard and turn on the schedule. Now the Lambda function over here is gonna have a global URL. We're gonna go pick it up. And also make sure to hit deploy so that the Lambda is actually updated globally. Okay, and we'll go to Smartproxy, and we're gonna add our Lambda URL here. Now, if we don't put console logs, we're not gonna see any output, but if you go to Cloudflare's log tab, you should be able to see if the Lambda is actually being called. And we can see we received a post request with an okay status. And double checking our database, we got our entry over here. Now, I'm not gonna be able to change the pizza search results for New Zealand easily, but what we can do is we can change the locale to see that the changes to the scraper are being saved. Just gonna change the locale to something like Spain. And gonna update the scraper. If your results do not arrive, you can either check Cloudflare logs, or you can also see the run histories on Smartproxy. And after changes to the locale, you can see we get the new URL, which is Domino's again, for Spain. So quick recap. We created a Google search scraping project. We connected the outputs from a scraper to a serverless function, and we saved those outputs into a database. Now, Smartproxy offers free trials for all scraping products, so you can head on over and get started for free. We'll see you all in the next video.